So good morning students, today we are going to be discuss the topic types of bond fission. Generally during a chemical reaction, the old bonds are broken, new bonds are formed. The cleavage of the bonds can be takes place in two ways in organic chemistry. One is homolytic fission, another one is heterolytic fission. That means homolytic cleavage, heterolytic cleavage. What is happening in the homolytic cleavage? So in the homolytic cleavage, the cleavage of covalent bond between the two atoms takes place in such a way that each atom retains one electron of the shared pair. That means whenever a covalent bond is broken between the two atoms, the two atoms are equally shared the electrons. That's why this cleavage or this fission is called symmetrical fission. Because of this cleavage, the neutral species are formed which are having the unpaired electrons. These species are called free radicals. Generally these are denoted by putting the dot over the symbol of atom or group of atoms. So the electron movement is shown by half-headed curved arrow like this. So let us take here A, B is a bond is formed by sharing of one electron pair. This electron pair is equally distributed between the two atoms by cleavage. A get one electron, B get one electron. So because of that one, each atom having one unpaired electron. So these are neutral species and these are called free radicals. Let us take the chlorine molecule. So the bond cleavage, that is homolytic fission, is takes place between the two chlorine atoms in the presence of a sunlight. So this bond means two electrons. These two electrons are equally shared by the two chlorine atoms. As a result, we are getting the chlorine free radical. That means simply in this cleavage, the covalent bond between the two atoms can be cleaved in such a way that each atom retains one electron of the shared pair. That is, we need to be remember one point. Second point is, because of this cleavage, so the neutral species are formed which are called free radicals, which are having the unpaired electron. The third one is, this cleavage can be represented by the half-headed curved arrow. So the second one is heterolytic fission. So it is different from the homolytic fission. In the homolytic fission, because of the cleavage of bond between the two atoms, both the bonded atoms are shared electrons equally. But in the heterolytic fission, it is an unsymmetrical, so that one of the atom can take both the electrons and the other one does not get any electron. So that it is unsymmetrical, so that one of the fragment takes both the electrons of the shared pair, leaving none on the other. So because of that, both the shared pair of electrons going to the one atom, the charged species are formed. So one atom has the sextet of electrons, therefore that is having the positive charge, while the other will have the octet with at least one lone pair, therefore has the negative charge. So the species that has the sextet at the carbon and is positively charged is called carbocation. Earlier it is called carbonium ion. The species that has the carbon atom with a shared pair of electrons and carrying a negative charge is called carbanion. That means, because of that heterolytic fission or heterolytic cleavage of a covalent bond between the two atoms in a molecule, resulted into the two charged species. One is carrying the positive charge, another one is carrying the negative charge. The positively charged species having the sextet electrons, six electrons around it. So it is generally called carbocation. The negatively charged species having the octet electrons with at least one lone pair around the carbon, that is called a carbanion. So here we can show A and B. So you are shifting of electrons towards the B completely. Both the electrons can be taken by the B. That's why the B get the negative charge. A can lose the electron. That's why A get the positive charge. Somebody may say, sir, why don't we like this? So why don't we shift it towards A? Okay. So electrons are now shifted to A. So B can lose the electron. A can gain both the electrons. That's why A minus B plus. Which side the bond is shifted? So that will be depends upon the reaction conditions. So that can be decided. So which atom get the positive charge, which one is get the negative charge. But anyway, the heterolytic fission is unsymmetrical. It is not like the homolytic fission. So during this heterolytic cleavage, one of the bonded atom gets the both the shared pair of electrons. The other atom does not get any electron. Whichever get the shared pair of electron, that get the negative charge. And whichever it get the, which atom does not get the any shared pair of electron, that is called carrying the positive charge. So if the positive charge is present on the carbon atom having the sextet electrons after the heterolytic fission, that is called carbocation. So after the heterolytic fission, if the carbon atom getting the negative charge and having the value of octet electrons around it, it is called carbanion. So totally homolytic fission and heterolytic fission. Homolytic fission is symmetrical, heterolytic fission is unsymmetrical. During the homolytic fission, neutral species are formed, they are called free radicals. During the heterolytic fission, the positively charged and negatively charged species are formed, they are called carbocation and carbanion. If the carbon having the positive charge and carbon having the negative charge respectively.